Coal has long been the bedrock of our electric grid, and although the industry is struggling nationwide, operators at this power plant say coal is key to keeping on our lights.
This is one of the reasons, a coal stockpile large enough to produce electricity for an entire month.
You could probably play several games of flag football up here. We have about 30, 35 acres worth of land is involved in this.
That's one of coal's benefits. It can be piled up right next to the power plant, ready to be made into electricity whenever. Natural gas and renewables are harder to store. So if there's a disruption, for example, in coal delivery by train.
So by having the stockpile here, it provides a guarantee that the units will be able to operate morning, noon, night, whatever time of the day it might be.
And so as the Environmental Protection Agency fights to implement a plan to cut carbon emissions from coal-fired power plants, warnings against those regulations are getting louder.
Power plant operators will tell you that the EPA's regulations fail to adequately protect electric grid reliability.
It's called the Clean Power Plan, and these regulations likely mean a lot more natural gas and renewables will come online. But that shift has actually been going on since the 1990s, and EPA officials strongly disagree that transitioning away from coal will threaten the flow of electricity.
This rule will not threaten the reliability of the energy supply system. There is absolutely no way in which that needs to be the case.
No matter how the Clean Power Plan changes electricity generation, all sources of energy do have costs.
Whatever we do for energy, there's a price to pay. And I think as a nation, that's really what the argument that we're going to be having over the next 20 years is, what is the price that we're willing to pay?
For Inside Energy, I'm Lee Patterson.